Hey guys, what's happening? Welcome to another episode in A Stronger Mind. I am Jakob Carlson, and today I'm going to talk to you about how you can go from being insecure to confident. An interesting study done with kids, that is kids that have grown up in protective homes and overprotective homes, that is a place where they have been kept away from risk, where they've been kept away from the possibility of getting just physically hurt during play, where they have been kept from getting rejected by friends. These kids have a higher chance of growing up to becoming insecure adults. And on the flip side, kids that have been growing up in a home where they have had the opportunity to play outside, to get physically hurt in play, and they have had the opportunity to get to know new kids, other kids, and to get rejected by these kids have a higher chance of growing up to becoming more confident adults. The interesting thing is that kids are naturally curious and interested in trying new things. And when a kid has the opportunity to be out and play, they have the freedom to try new things. While they are getting hurt, either physically or emotionally, by the way they fall in play, or by the way their friend hurt them and reject them, or by the way they fail when they try at something, they're learning a very important lesson early on. They learn that failure, and they learn that rejection, and they learn that pain is a part of life, and they learn how to get over this and to go out and play again, or how to go out and hang out with their friends again, or how to move on from the pain. They stay curious and they grow in confidence in themselves that they can overcome things that come their way, they can stand up for themselves, and so on. On the flip side, the kid that is grown up in the house where they have been sitting inside, they have been kept away from people or from the ability to try to play outside. Well, these kids are eventually going to have to step outside of the world. They go to high school or they go and get a job, and they are overwhelmed by the fact that they notice people have bad intentions, and there are actually people that are going to reject them, and they are going to experience expectation in the workplace and the responsibility that if they fail to meet these expectation, they are going to have consequences. And in many cases, these kids that have been raised in overprotective homes, they get overwhelmed and they give up, and that is a sad truth. So if you're an adult or an adolescent and you are afraid of asking someone on a date, or you are afraid of going on a job interview, or you're afraid of hanging out in groups, the chances are that you need to be like the kid that is curious and that puts himself at risk. You have to go out there and put yourself in situations where you can experience pain, failure, and hurt. If not, if you avoid rejection, well, you're going to keep daydreaming about being in a relationship. If you avoid challenges, well, you're going to be in your current job situation. If you avoid risk, well, you're probably not going to change very much. So if you can tell that you need to grow in confidence, the two things that you have to do is you have to be vulnerable and you have to be courageous, and you have to practice these things. So a simple way of practicing vulnerability and courage to becoming more confident, that is standing up for yourself, putting boundaries in place. Let's use a pretty simple example, that is someone is talking trash at you. Someone is disrespecting you and you don't appreciate it. You have two options. You can either accept the poor treatment and the disrespect, or you can do the powerful act, the courageous act, what the confident person would do, that is simply telling the person or the people that, hello, I don't appreciate the way you're talking to me, I don't appreciate the way you're treating me, and I would like you to stop. Now, you would be very vulnerable and very courageous to do this. You would be a powerful person because you're now putting yourself in the situation where you can get a storm back. Chances are that if you stand up for yourself, the people that you speak to might not like it. And if you have been someone who has never spoken up for yourself, the people might notice, and they are not going to tolerate it, and they're going to come harder back at you, and you're probably going to fail at this. You're probably going to get a verbal beating, maybe even a physical beating, I don't know, depending on where you're living and what is your situation is. But you stood up for yourself, that is saying no. And even if you failed, you still did the right thing, you still valued yourself. That is good. Another way to practice courage and vulnerability to become a confident individual, that is something that I learned in my 1 year service in the Norwegian army, which was mandatory. Our lieutenant took us to a pool where we had to jump a 5 meter jump. So we were at the top of this pool and in this jump, and our lieutenant said, I want you to jump, but I want you to jump in a way that you're afraid of doing that you have never done before. And I've jumped from a 5 meter jump before. I was not really afraid of it. And I had never done a front flip from a 5 meter jump because I've always been afraid of getting hurt. So obviously I've never done it. And this day I chose to go against the fear and I chose to do the jump. I landed on my side and it hurt a lot, and I failed miserably. And I went back up there and he said, now I want you to do something more difficult. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna do it. I chose to do a backflip. I landed mostly on my back and it was really painful and I failed miserably. Although it was painful and it sucked, I learned a really important lesson in life from my lieutenant that day. That is, if you want to get anything out of life, if you want to do anything, you have to expect pain and you have to expect failure. With this being said, I'm gonna practice what I preach and I will do this challenge with you guys today. So let's watch this next clip.
So I tried a running backflip, that was really useless. So now I'm gonna do a standard standing front flip. Okay, that was a successful standing front flip. And to challenge myself, I'll do a running front flip.